I'm not what you would call a Call of Duty aficionado, somebody that, you know, knows the ins and outs of every single gun and every single mechanic, but I do know what I like. I do like a new map. But I do want to talk to you about the brand new map for Call of Duty Cold War Apocalypse. And I want to talk about five cool things in like 5 minutes that you should know about for this map. That episode is right now. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Assemble. I am Matt. How you doing? Happy Friday. It's the weekend. We made it past hump day. There's no humps here. It's a weekend. We get some cocktails. We get the popcorn. We watch an old movie. Watch something new. We got lots of gaming stuff going on. And today we're going to talk about Call of Duty some more. I enjoy myself some COD. And I want to talk specifically about Apocalypse. No, not that Apocalypse. I do appreciate that Apocalypse though. The best Apocalypse. The one from the movies? Shame. For shame. They did that. Give me OG cartoon 90s Apocalypse. Way better. Anyways, getting off track. Call of Duty, Black Ops, Cold War, Apocalypse map. Five things that are really kind of great about this map. I like to be positive here on the show. So five things that are great about this map, starting with number one, size. Nah, it's size, not his size, not my size. Get your mind out of the gutter. But the map size, it's a small, medium map size, 6v6 players for things like team deathmatch, kill confirms. You got the 24/7 mode going on in there. Hardpoint, we'll get to that in a little bit. But the map size itself, I think they do a really good job with the Apocalypse map of not making it too spread out. They keep it very tight, which does play into a lot of the gameplay style and the way that you can go about the different missions and modes within this. And for 6v6, I mean, I always like to be able to think about like having like large scale battles and fights and all of that. I don't like my 3v3. And I do think that 6v6 is actually a good little medium. And this map does a really good job of pulling in those great elements of Call of Duty from narrow corridors by jumping through little tiny huts and buildings, being able to get a little bit more of the like underground, going through the temple. There's places to duck and to shoot off into the side. There's a lot of different ways that you can play within this map, and that's what makes the size of it feel really good and very Call of Duty-ish. That's number one. Number two, Hardpoint Chaos, I call it. Hardpoint Chaos because Hardpoint is really, really good in my opinion and really, really fun within this map. When I'm playing hard, I'm finding that I'm playing Hardpoint a lot more, especially with this brand new map that came out. And what I'm noticing is that I'm gonna go and play team deathmatch, maybe some kill confirm, but I really enjoy Hardpoint within this because of the way they have spaced them out, the rotation of each Hardpoint as they go through. And because it's a small, medium-sized map, you feel like you are just constantly jumping from one Hardpoint to the other, and I'm not having to go from one other side of the map to the other. So you're timing to go from one Hardpoint to the next. It's a matter of seconds, right? But I feel like they did a good job with this map because of the size of it. It creates a little bit more intensity when it comes to Hardpoint. I don't feel like in other maps where I feel like we just gain a Hardpoint and that's it and nothing else happens with it. This one, I feel like it's constantly happening. It's constantly moving and I'm always having to watch my back to see which angle people are gonna come and flank from. And it creates some really good intense moments for it. Number three on this list is gonna be, I'm saying that this map specifically is a great way to increase your XP and give yourself a little bit of an XP boost. If you can find yourself to be able to get an XP boost that even does even better, so like I've been able to get those 15-minute boosts or the 1-hour boost in there as well. And I think that when you can do, if you wanna be able to build up one of your rifles, if you wanna be able to build it up and get some new unlockables, some new perks, and really boost up your XP, this is a really good map for that because it's a little bit on the smaller size. If you have enough skill, I do not, I am not that good. But when I do get a kill and a kill confirm, I like that I get to rack up my boost and I get a few more points in there. It makes Matt happy. Feeling good and I go again and I go again and then 3 hours have gone by and I'm getting yelled at because I haven't helped make dinner and I've just been crushing online, but mostly getting my ass kicked. It's a great XP builder if you guys are looking to build up a brand new rifle and weapon set. I think that you should go into Apocalypse and play into that map. I think it'll do a really good job to help you guys out. Number four, it's a rifleman's dream, I say, because for me, I am using my rifle. I am enjoying it so, so much. And I think that if you're going to use a rifle in this map, not a sniper rifle, come on, we can't do that. Using your assault rifles are probably, you're gonna argue against me and you're gonna say that it's something else and you have a whole different class and it's way better than Matt's. That's fine. But I think that the assault rifle class is the one that you want to be able to use within this map to be able to get your sights down quickly, to be able to get everything moving, to get an extended mag is also going to help you out in this map too, because of the size of it, and it's a little more condensed, you're gonna be shooting them off. I would say it's gonna be an assault rifle's dream, or you're gonna end up with a shotgun, because I'm enjoying that too, and I use the shotgun as my secondary weapon, because as soon as we're getting into a hard point or anything like that, I'm noticing that I'm like, I gotta switch off into my shotgun to get those guys and shoot him in the head. It's so dark. COD is such a dark game. And talking evil, shooting people in faces. It's hilarious, but it's disturbing. Number five on this list for today, ladies and gentlemen, is good spawn points. Yes, I like the spawn points within this map. I think that they're spread out enough. I don't feel like I am just getting, you know, destroyed as soon as I spawn like I do in other maps. That's one thing that always drives me nuts with Call of Duty, is that because of the speed and the franticness of it sometimes, that there people are, as soon as I'm spawning, that I am getting just destroyed within seconds and I don't have time to actually, you know, figure out where I am. But with this one, I think the spawn points are spread out very well. There's only a couple of instances where you are towards like the very beginning section of the map that I feel like they're kind of these hot spots to be able to pick people off if you want to go that route. So if you want to get that more XP, it's a good way to pop people off. But they're spread out enough that it gives you enough time to get yourself situated, to figure out other areas of the map that you want to go through, the little huts, the houses. If you want to be able to, you know, hop over and go into more of the temple area, you guys can do that too. There's a lot of different spots to be able to spawn in this thing. And again, it makes it so that it's a little bit more of a fair playground versus that of something where you're just respawning and you toast. So guys, there's five things that can help you that are nice, that are positive about the Apocalypse map here in Black Ops Cold War into the season two of this whole thing. And I'm really enjoying myself. I am getting my ass handed to me and it's being chewed out and spat out again, but I'm having a good time. I'm enjoying myself. It's been fun. What maps are you enjoying overall with Call of Duty right now with Black Ops Cold War? Are you enjoying the new Apocalypse now? And what modes within that are you guys playing the most? And I'd love to hear about it. Let me know in the comments below. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us here on Assemble. I am Matt. And as always, thank you guys for assembling with us. Now, I am going to go. I'm going to go play Call of Duty right now. I'm going to get destroyed again for the third time. My kill death ratio actually yesterday, I'm not gonna lie, not bad. It's five. See ya.